I love perfume, and who doesn't? Women and men, isn't it? Here are some facts about perfumes. Perfume comes from Latin perfumus, which means through smoke. The first sensory smokes of the burnt odorous materials. In the Western cultures, perfume is applied at pulse points like behind the ears, the nape of the neck, and the insides of wrists, elbows, and knees. So pulse would warm the perfume and release it into the air. Others say that perfume also should be applied on clothing and hair. Opinions differ because perfume can leave stains on clothes. When the weather is hotter, a lower amount of perfume should be applied. Also, light and fresh perfumes are recommended for such weather. Perfumes that contain alcohol, which is most of them, can cause dryness in hair, so perfume should not be applied to hair too often. Scents that have floral notes are not a good idea to be worn in parks and open air, natural places, because they can attract insects. If your skin is dry, perfume will not last long. You should first apply petroleum jelly or some type of skin moisturizer, and then perfume, which will prolong odor. Many skin lotions work well for this purpose. Perfumes are best kept in cool, moderate room temperature, dry and dark place. The first fashion designer to design her own signature smell was Coco Chanel. It's now famous Chanel No. 5. My husband keeps on buying me new perfumes, and what I'm going to show you now, believe it or not, is his hobby. He loves to buy miniature sets. Usually he buys them in a plane or the tax-free shops at airports. Aren't they adorable?